Good morning, students. Welcome to the chemistry theory online classes. And in our last class, we have discussed about the physical properties of the ether and few examples which are based on the Williamson ether synthesis. Those examples we have already discussed in our last video class. And in today's class, we are going to discuss about the chemical reactions of the ethers. How exactly ethers will going to react with other chemicals or other reagent? Those are nothing but the chemical reactions of the ethers. So usually ethers are nothing but the formula is general formula is ROR or R dash you can take, that is symmetrical as well as unsymmetrical ether will be there. So here usually the ethers are the less reactive. First of all, ethers are very less reactive. So in order to make them reactive, in order to make them active, we have to maintain certain conditions like high temperature, and by taking the excessive of the reagent you can use. First of all, the ether itself is a less reactive. Ether is less reactive. So in order to make it more reactive, in order to make it more reactive, you have to maintain the high temperature. So even though if it is a less reactive, you want to make it reactive, or you want to make it to involve in the chemical reaction, means you have to follow up the high temperature, or you have to maintain the high temperature, and even you can use the excess of the reagent. Okay, then only ethers can able to give us the chemical reactions. And here C-O bond cleavage will going to be takes place. C-O bond cleavage will going to be takes place. Okay, so let us go for the chemical reaction part. The first one is the reaction with the hydrogen halide. Whenever ethers are going to react with the hydrogen halide, during that time what is the formation that we are going to discuss? The first reaction is reaction with hydrogen halide. Reaction with hydrogen halide. See here, this is our ether, yes or no? This is the ether. So whenever it is treated with the hydrogen halide, it means HX. So what happens here? This bond will going to be break, or this bond will going to be break. It means R is nothing but carbon, that is alkyl group. CO bond breaking will going to be takes place. So one of the product is alcohol, that is ROH, or else you can write like this, ROH plus. Suppose this is ROH, and what else remained? RX. So RX, alcohol and alkyl halide is formed. Alkyl halide is formed. Okay, and as I said you, we are going to take the excess of the reagent, like hydrogen halide must be taken excess. Even you can use excess of reagent, instead of that you can use excess of the hydrogen halide. Okay, so if I am using more hydrogen halide, means that further will going to react with this alcohol. This alcohol and hydrogen halide react with each other. So see here, there is a elimination of the water molecule H2O. Okay, so what is one more product? RX plus H2O. Okay, so if we want to write the reaction in a single reaction, that is overall reaction, what will be the ether is reacts with two molecules of the hydrogen halide, two molecules of the hydrogen halide, and how many molecules of the alkyl halide are formed? Two. See here, R and R, I will make it two, and 2X it is, then what is removed? H2O. So this is the overall reaction you can able to say. So here one conclusion we can able to give: dialkyl ether, di means two, the two alkyl, dialkyl ether is going to give us two molecules of the alkyl halide. two molecules of the alkyl halide. I hope so it is clear for you. First one is the reaction with the hydrogen halide we are discussing. The reaction with the hydrogen halide, here ether is treated with hydrogen halide. So there is a formation of the alcohol with alkyl halide. As we are taking, the reaction will going to be still continue because we are taking HX to the excessive quantity. So the alcohol will going to react with this hydrogen halide. So there is a formation of the one more unit of the alkyl halide with the release of the water. Suppose if I want to show this one in a overall single reaction, means the dialkyl ether is treated with two units of the hydrogen halide so that it can able to form the two units of the alkyl halide with the release of the water. So this is how exactly the reaction of the hydrogen halide will going to be takes place. Suppose then in a case of hydrogen halide, that is HX, if we discuss about the reactivity, usually the reactivity of this HX series will be you can say is in such a way that HI is more reactive because in case of HI, it can easily give its H plus. It acts as a somewhat more acidic as compared with HBr, as compared with the HI. As compared with the HCl, and HF is not easily formed because fluorine is more electronegative and smaller size. That's why. And then one more thing, this is the reactivity of the HX series, that is always HI is more reactive compared with HBr compared with the HCl. Clear? So this is if I am taking the alkyl ether, that is if I am taking alkyl ether, suppose one of the group is here, suppose this one of the alkyl group is aryl. If it is aryl, during that time what happens? See here, let me take this one as an example. So this is alkyl aryl ether. Okay, the name of this compound is alkyl aryl ether. Okay, and we are treating this alkyl aryl with hydrogen halide, that is HX. See here, what happens? There is a two possibility, I will tell you. Here always the CO bond breaking will going to be takes place, that I said you, and here also CO bond going to be broken or it will be cleave. And here what happens, this R is nothing but any alkyl group like CH3, C2H5, like this, any alkyl group. It means it includes the carbon itself. Either we can able to break this CO bond, or you can able to break, here also carbon will be there in the aryl, and this is also the CO bond, or you can able to break this bond. Then which one is easy? See here, always the alkyl group CO bond will going to be cleave. Why? Because here in case of aryl ring, what happens, due to the resonance effect, the partial double bond is going to be developed here. That's why the breaking of this CO bond is not possible. So this is the reason in case of here aryl, that is in the benzene ring, the resonance will going to be takes place. Due to the resonance effect, the double bond, partial double bond will going to be developed here as a double bond, and this carbon is sp2 hybridized. So I said you in the previous classes also, sp2 hybridized carbon bond length will be shorter. To break that bond, we need more energy. So in between these two, this bond breaking is easy. Okay, that's why what happens here, this CO bond will going to be broken. So what will going to be formed? This hydrogen will going to be attack here, R will going to get attached with the X. So see here, there is a formation of the phenol will going to be takes place with the release of water, with the release of the RX, with the release of the alkyl halide, See here, further reaction is not possible. Here further reaction is possible because here alcohol ROH is formed. Here it will again it will going to give us. But in case of alkyl aryl ether, it is the reaction will going to be stop here itself. It will not going to react with one more molecule of the HX. Clear? So this is how we can explain about the reaction with the hydrogen halide and the reactivity series if the reaction is carried out by taking the alkyl aryl ether. So let me explain you the mechanism of this reaction. So just look at the mechanism. It is very interesting. So here I will take, okay, ethyl methyl ether I am going to take. So ether is reacting with the hydrogen halide called as HI. Then what is the product? That we are going to discuss. So here mechanism, first step one. Step one I will tell you. As I said you, ether is, this is the ether. It is less reactive. To make it reactive, first you have to protonate it. Okay, the proton, first step is protonation of ether. Protonation of ether will going to be takes place. So the protonation means here oxygen is a electronegative and obviously it will going to attract the hydrogen and this bond is shifted to the iodine. So what happens here? CH3 as it is. For this oxygen, C2H5 is there. I will write C2H5 as it is. Then what else? It is attracts the hydrogen. That hydrogen I am going to write here. So as oxygen is bivalent, but here three bonds are occurred. So the oxygen gets the positive charge. And then what else remain? I minus. Iodide ion is liberated. So this is the first step. Protonation of the ether is done. So in case of second step, step two. What is step two? This ion, that is iodine ion, iodide, will going to attack on this what is for protonated ether. It will going to attack on the protonated ether. Just look at here. This is C2H5, and then here it is CH3, and here it is a H. Now our this ion will going to attack. There is a one question. It might be attack on this carbon because it is, and it might be attack on this carbon. So you, there might be some confusion in your mind. This H can able to donate the bond here. It can liberate, so the oxygen will going to be satisfied. If I did the same thing, means why we have to attack HI? Again the similar will going to be occur, no? If I am removing this H, means again CH3O C2H5 is the our reactant, but we won't want it. Okay, so that's why this is not going to be takes place. This iodide will going to attack on the carbon, but there are two carbons. For which carbon it will going to prefer? This iodide ion prefer the carbon which is less substituted or less hindered, you can say. In between these two, CH3 is less hindered. So definitely it will going to attack on it. So definitely it will going to attack on this. So what happens here? This will going to attack on the CH3, and this CH3, its bond is shifted to the oxygen. So what happens here? CH3I, that is methyl iodide, is separated out. This part is separated. Then what else remained? C2H5, and this is the oxygen. This is the, yes or no? So this is the first step, that is step two, but still the reaction is not at all stopped. We want to prepare the alkyl halide that we got, but even we have the excess of the HI. So what happens one more time in case of step three? In case of step three, what happens? Again, the HI will going to attack on here. Just see here, C2H5O H plus HI, okay, because we are taking the hydrogen iodide excessive. So here further again this is electronegative and this will going to take its hydrogen, and this bond is shifted to the iodine. It is separated out. So
what is prepared? C2H5 oxygen, and this is the hydrogen, and one more hydrogen here it is attached, plus I minus.
Yes or no? I minus. So again, here only this iodine further attacks on the oxygen. So what happens here, when this iodine will going to attack on the carbon, not oxygen, as I said you in the previous, CH3 is less hindered, it attacks the carbon, but here only C2H5 is remained. It will going to attack on the C2H5, that is ethyl group, and H2O is eliminated. So the final product is C2H5I plus H2O. That is, here methyl iodide is formed, here ethyl iodide is formed. So this is the mechanism of the how we are going to treat the ether with the hydrogen halide to form the alkyl halide. In the throat reaction, two alkyl halide, one is methyl iodide, one more is ethyl iodide is obtained. So once again I will explain you the mechanism, just look at that. See here, the mechanism of the reaction of the ethyl methyl ether with hydrogen halide, that is hydrogen iodide. Okay, the first step is, as I said you, ether is less reactive. To make it reactive, we have to protonate it. So we are using the acid, okay, and then that is HI. So here what happens, oxygen is more electronegative and H is it will going to be attack on that, those will be going to form a bond, so that the ether is protonated. This is the protonated ether. So oxygen got the three bonds, it gets the positive charge, and iodide in the form of iodine, in the form of its ion, will going to be liberated. So in the second step, this I minus only attacks on the protonated ether. Then there is a one question, whether it will prefer this carbon or this carbon. It will prefer the carbon which is less substituted. So it will prefer the CH3. Suppose this I will going to attack, this bond is shifted here. So what is the product? CH3I plus here C2OH, C2H5OH, okay. That only I have written, C2H5OH. Now in the third step, we are taking excess of the HI. That is concentrated HI. This reaction is treated with a concentrated only, okay. Then excess of the concentrated HI is taken further. This will going to react with HI. Similar, first protonation takes place and then I minus will going to attack on it. So when I minus attacks on it, and this water molecule is eliminated, and the final product is C2H5I is the final product with the elimination of the water. So one more bit of that concept only I want to explain you. Till now whatever I have explained, that is follow up the SN2 mechanism. Suppose the primary secondary alkyl group is there in the ether. Suppose the tertiary alkyl group is there in the ether, means during that time it follow up the SN1 mechanism. Then might be some confusion in your mind, that I will explain you. Suppose primary and secondary alkyl group is there, during that time what happens, it follow up SN2 mechanism. Suppose tertiary is there, tertiary alkyl group is there, means it follow up the SN1. What is the meaning of primary? See here, just now whatever I said, I shown here, this carbon is primary. Now I want to show you tertiary. See here, suppose this is the tertiary alkyl group, like this, it is tertiary because this carbon is attached to the further, okay, and then here you can take the CH3. So it is a tertiary alkyl group. Suppose if we are having the tertiary alkyl ether, during that time tertiary dialkyl ether, you can say, during that time how does the mechanism occurs? So as I am telling you, it follow up the SN1 mechanism, there must be formation of the carbocation. So before forming the carbocation, first it undergoes protonation. As I said you, it reacts with HI, and this and I gets separated out. So what is the product here? See here, CH3, and then here also CH3, and this hydrogen, it got the positive charge. Okay, so what happens? This is protonation. In here, this bond is shifted to the carbon in order to make it carbocation, and this CH3OH is eliminated. So there is a formation of the carbocation first. See here, CH3 plus CH3OH. So there is a formation of the carbocation takes place in the step 1. So as I said you, in case of SN1, there is a formation of the carbocation. This is the carbocation will going to be formed. Next, in the step 2, what happens is it is the slow. Okay, in the step 2, for this only, this carbocation, this I minus will going to be attack. Okay, so this is the reaction will going to be takes place when we are taking the tertiary alkyl group in the ether. It means it follow up the, our intention is to tell you that here SN1 mechanism will going to be takes place, but in the previous mechanism we have shown it is of the SN2, it follow up the SN2 mechanism, but here it follow up the SN1 mechanism. So first step is addition, that is the formation of the carbocation. Okay, further next I minus will going to be attack on it, there is a formation of the, this product will going to be occurs, and it involves the two steps. First one is the slow and the second one is the fast step. Okay, so this is how we are going to take the tertiary group. Suppose instead of alkyl, if I am taking, that is alkyl aryl ether. So this is the, just now I have explained you, alkyl aryl ether. Suppose I am taking alkyl aryl ether, and this alkyl aryl is treated with again hydrogen halide. Again it is treated with the hydrogen halide. Same thing for this oxygen, hydrogen will going to be attacked. Okay, so what happens here, and this bond is shifted here and I minus is separated out. This is the benzene ring. Okay, and hydrogen is attached here, CH3 is attached here, this is plus, and then what else is here, I minus is separated out. Further, this I minus attacks on the CH3 and this bond is shifted to the oxygen. So what happens, CH3I, this is the phenol formation will going to be takes place with the release of the methyl iodide, and there is a formation of the phenol takes place. Okay, further if I am treating this with HI, the reaction does not takes place, no reaction. Okay, there is no reaction, phenol is the final product. If it I am taking instead of alkyl aryl halide ether, if I am taking dialkyl ether, means further one more step is possible, but when I am taking anisole, this particular example, the name of this compound is anisole. So during that time phenol is formed with the release of the methyl iodide. Okay, so one more time I am telling you, if the primary and secondary alkyl group is there, it follow up the SN2 mechanism. If there is a tertiary alkyl group is there, it follow up SN1 mechanism. It carries out in the two steps. First one we have to protonate it to make the ether reactive. First step is protonation. And in the protonation part, what happens? There is a, this CH3OH molecule is eliminated to make a carbocation. And this step is the slowest, and it is also called as a rate determining step, RDS. Okay. And then the formed carbocation is attacked by the I minus to form the product. This is the SN1 mechanism. Suppose instead of taking dialkyl ether, okay, if I am taking any aryl group, that is alkyl aryl ether, particular example we are talking about the anisole. When this anisole is treated with hydrogen halide, during that time what happens? Again protonation takes place. and I minus separate out. And this I minus attacks on the CH3, there is a formation of the phenol will going to be takes place with the elimination of the methyl iodide. So this is how we are going to explain about the chemical reaction which is involving the ether, that is 2. The ether is going to react with hydrogen halide. That ether may be dialkyl ether or it may be alkyl aryl ether. Clear? I hope so it is clear for you people, and if you have any doubts in the mechanism, just go through the video one more time, so we will get the clarity. And in our next class we are going to discuss one more last reaction, that is the last bit of the topic. Until that, keep watching the video. Thank you.